Right. We're good. I'm live. Yep. We're going. All right. Hello, everyone watching Os-a-Thon. I'm Nerd Squared. I run a lot of different games, way too many games, in fact, at this point. Today, in particular, I'll be running Half-Life Alyx. It's the first Half-Life game in a long time, which is very exciting stuff. But I'm not going to be running the main campaign today. Although the main campaign is a very good run. We're running this right here. This is Levitation. This is a fan-made campaign made by a very talented team of developers. And what's interesting about it is that, like I said, it's a fan-made campaign, but it's actually a full campaign with a story and pretty involved levels and everything. It's not just like a test map that someone uploaded to the Steam Workshop. It's a full campaign with 8 chapters, one map each, and I'll be playing through it ideally fast today, because you'll see very quickly that it is a very bonkers route already, even though I'm pretty much the only runner and the sole glitch hunter. But there's just a lot of cool stuff going on. You'll see very soon what I mean by that. I have a webcam here because it is a VR game, as you can see. I think the camera's right around there. This is a VR game, so you're going to see plenty of silliness IRL for sure, because there's a lot of IRL movement involved in this run. It's a very physical speed run for sure. I'll be doing like ducking up and down to go out of bounds. There's some pretty sick stuff. All right, so we'll go ahead and start. Time doesn't start there, by the way. I'm timing on my side. It starts when I do my first little movement input. But we have a bit of a cutscene at the start. I did mention this is a fan-made campaign for Half-Life Alyx. This is pretty much what this game would be like if it got like with Half-Life 2 how it had episode 1 and 2. This is pretty much the episode 1 and 2 for Half-Life Alyx, because this is a kind of a direct sequel of sorts to the main Half-Life Alyx campaign. At the end of the main HLA campaign, we got in that area there. That's the vault. We go in there to free who we think is Gordon Freeman, but it's actually the G-Man. And he's gonna give us a little speech here at the beginning, as is typical with Half-Life games. And there he is. So, with this cutscene, we can't do anything for a couple minutes until G-Man finishes his speech, so we'll just play around for a little bit. You can just slap G-Man there if you want. He doesn't have any collision. So yeah, like I said, this is a sequel. It's right after the main campaign. We crash the vault there, and we get put in stasis by G-Man. And we get out of stasis here in this cutscene. Hey, Strider. We get brought out of stasis in this cutscene because this game and the main campaign of HLA takes place a little bit before Half-Life 2. Where we're trying to fight against the Combine C-17. And we find out from this briefing, as well as some dialogue that we'll be avoiding seeing, that there's these two people from the Combine Resistance, Barry and Maya. They go to this levitating building, hence the name Levitation. And the goal of this game is basically to go and find them. So I'm going to start time here, which is a little tricky, but I'll manage. Actually, let me make sure I'm tabbed into the timer. Alright, I am. Just gotta make sure my hand's on the timer. Alright, so we'll start as soon as I start teleporting here to move. And there we go, we're off. So you'll notice as I do this first map, or series of maps, I guess, and I'm moving very, very fast, much faster than you're normally supposed to. That's trickle fast teleporting. I'll explain what it is in a second. Because I have to hit a couple triggers here to activate the load points at the end of this act, or chapter, which is right here. So anyways, what I was doing there was something called fast teleporting. So you have two ways of moving around in this game. You can either just move with a stick, or move your body IRL. Or you can teleport like this by using the stick, whether it's left stick if you're in shift mode, or right stick if you're in continuous mode, like I am right now. However, you can also bind the teleport button to one of the grip buttons on my Oculus controllers right here. Which, by the way, I'm on Oculus Quest 2 for this. And within that, you can go into the SteamVR controller bindings and set the activation threshold to 10% or so, so just something like really low value. And then the deactivation threshold to 100%. And that makes it so that when I hold down the button, it'll spam teleport every other frame. So I'll be doing that a lot throughout the whole run because it's significantly faster than just moving with stick or moving my IRL body. I also did a little trick there called extended jumping. Like I said, you teleport by just pointing the stick or using fast teleport button, and you get to where you need to go near instantaneously. However, if in the middle of teleporting, you pause the game and then move IRL, you can extend where you're going, hence why we call it extended jump. And you can use that to go through basically any barrier or wall. So I'll be doing that like right here to go through doors. And we'll be doing it a lot in this next room coming up to go through a few barriers. I have to shoot this Combine Soldier first though, just so he's not an issue as I try to clip here. So I'll do a few extended jumps here. Oh, I kind of missed that one. Oh, come on, this one can be a bit of a nuisance sometimes. Because it's a pretty far extended jump, but got that. So I'm going to extended jump through these barriers. You're normally supposed to take down these barriers by turning off the power, and along the way you'd fight a few Combine Soldiers. But we have extended jumps and can go right through any door. So we just go through those barriers with extended jumping. So when I do this map, by the way, we're already on chapter 3. When I do this next map, I'm gonna dupe ammo by grabbing ammo packs, my backpack, and then very quickly putting it back in. The game does not deplete my ammo count because it can't react fast enough to change my ammo count. So it just adds one stack for each stack I put back in. I'm gonna duplicate to about 100 ammo. That looks good. Now I'm gonna do this. So what I just did was something called zero zipping. So I mentioned before that you could fast teleport. And what I did is I fast teleported, and while I was in the middle of fast teleporting, I teleported with the right stick. And when you do that set of motions, there's a brief moment where the foot indicator that shows where you're teleporting disappears. And if you pause while you're in that little window, and then you go into the menu and switch your movement to a shift, which by the way, there's multiple different movement modes. If you switch your movement to shift and unpause, you'll confuse the game, and because the game doesn't know what to do with your positioning as a result of you trying to teleport really fast. And so it just zips you to the origin of the map. And conveniently, the origin of the map for that chapter is right on top of the train at the end of the chapter. You normally have to do a big fight sequence there where you shoot some Combine Soldiers through windows on the train, but we can completely avoid that. I'm going to do another zero zip here. That clips me inside the ceiling though, so I have to do a quick save load to get in. Because when you're trapped partially inside of a ceiling like that, and you save and load, you'll get put on top of wherever you were stuck. Now we're in chapter 4. Already you're doing some craziness with zero zipping. Normally in this chapter, you'd have to deal with a character called Jeff, which if you've played the main HLA campaign, you know who that character is. He's a pretty terrifying enemy that acts, oddly enough, a lot like a clicker in The Last of Us. That's the example I have for it anyway. But we're going to go out of bounds and completely avoid any instance of interacting with Jeff. Because trying to avoid Jeff is very slow, so obviously we don't want to do that. The game lags a lot here because this level in particular is very big. And so it takes a lot of processing power to try to load the entire area. So I'm going to extend a jump through that because I want to get on top of this train and I need to very carefully navigate out of bounds here to get right around there because surrounding this train car that I'm on is a crap ton of death triggers. So I need to be very careful not to hit them. Got down just fine though. And I'm going to do an extended jump to get in this train. It's the toughest extended jump in the game because it's extremely... I have to do an extremely far extended jump to get in this train. And and I have to do a very precise teleport on top of that. So it's not worth doing the fast teleport method I was doing before to clip through walls. I have to be very precise with it. Yeah, it takes a second to set this up, so this might take a little bit. Just very carefully set it up. Okay. I think I need to move a bit farther back for this to work. Come on. Like I said, it's very precise. You have to fiddle with it to make it work. You can see even if I move the cursor a tiniest bit, that foot indicator goes out of alignment. There we go, that looks good. So now I'm going to move IRL pretty far to clip into the train. And we got in. Need to teleport up here though, so I can grab this ladder and get up. I'm going to pause here just so I can reorient myself to do another extended jump to this train door. I'm going to save here because we're going to have a very close encounter with Jeff trying to do this to clip through the ceiling. Which thankfully isn't too bad. So I'll just do a quick save load to get on top of the train. To get through these ceilings, I'm doing a trick called height adjusting. Again, another Steam VR / HLA accessibility feature. There's a button you can use to crouch and stand up. So what I'm doing is I'm crouching IRL and then uncrouching with the button. And that makes me go much higher than I'm normally able to. And that's how I'm able to clip through these ceilings. I'm doing a big roundabout path here at the what's basically the end of the map already, because... Oh, what? I didn't make it? Looks like I'll have to do another one. Thought for sure it'll clip me through. Oh, my bank is where I saved. That makes sense. That's fine, I can just try it again real quick. So I'm doing this, like I was saying, I'm doing this big roundabout path to get around Jeff. Because normally you'd have to, like I said earlier, you do a section where you try to stealthily move past him. But that's very slow. And you'd also have to do a puzzle to unlock that door. But instead, we're going to try to clip into there. That way we avoid having to interact with Jeff. There we go. So I've done the extended jump and I'll clip through here. Same with this door, so we don't have to do the puzzle in this room. It's supposed to go off to the side and turn on the power so you can enter this elevator. I'm just going to extend and jump through this, hit the button, and we're out of here. So by far and away the most involved chapter in the entire game, because there's a lot of height adjusting to get through ceilings in the map, but turned out okay. I fumbled on one of the height adjusts, but it turned out alright. So now we're in Chapter 5, Pleasantville. This is another one of those really big skips with extended jumping and whatnot. I'm gonna have to wait a little bit here, though. By the way, that's a new enemy type right there. It's a kind of a sort of a manta ray that's electric. And normally, as we go along in the chapter, we'd have to kill those electric manta rays, which I don't know the actual enemy name, but that's all I'm going to call them. We'd have to kill those electric manta rays and basically get their egg sacs, essentially, to power doors. We're going to try to avoid those puzzles by doing some extended jumping. This one here just skips to this electric puzzle. Right here. And I have to lean into the environment a little bit, so I pop up above the floor there. So I can go over here and skip another puzzle involving those electric manta rays. Now we have to do a quick puzzle. We have to interact with these levers in a specific order, going along with the color of the cords that are attached to these pumps. It's basically we go from red to orange and these two yellow switches, and then this blue one to end off with. That cuts off the power to the fans so we can actually interact with this elevator at the bottom, right here. And we're at the end of the chapter. So we're probably maybe 10 odd minutes in, and we're already over halfway through the game. As you can see, extended jumps and zero zips and whatnot break this game quite a bit. And that's not the end of it, though, because we're going to do another extended jump, or extended jump, zero zip here, start of this chapter. So I'll do a quick zero zip there. And I'm going to, if I let the zero zip continue, though, I get pulled out of bounds, so I have to catch myself there by fast teleporting. So I'll do a quick extended jump through this. I'm going to save here just in case I die. There's a lot of enemies here, and if I take a lot of damage, I can die pretty easily here. Levitation, especially when you play as casually, is a very hard game. Because like here, when you're climbing this tower, the game puts a bunch of enemies in your way. And if you just ran past them willy-nilly, kind of like what I'm doing here, you would very quickly just get demolished. But we got speed tricks up our sleeve, so we don't have to worry about that too much. I do have 2 hearts, so I have to be kind of careful. Because I'm going to encounter a lot of Combine Soldiers here. They can very easily demolish me if I'm not careful. So I have to be really careful with my health. And I'm pretty low right now, so I have to... I'm kind of in the danger zone here. But I should be okay. That being said, I'm low-key a little scared. Oh my gosh. Okay, so I think what happened is there was a Combine Soldier upstairs and they just nicked me somehow. So this is a little scary now because I'm basically on 0 health and I have to get past like a manhack and 2 big Combine Soldiers. So we'll see what I can do here. Because now this is very, this is like mock-ass mode right now, essentially. In fact, I'm going to save after I kill every enemy. Okay. Okay, that looks fine. Yeah, like I said, I'm on very low health, so I take a single hit, I'm done for. So I have to be, like, very careful now to avoid shots in this. One Combine Soldier, okay? We have this one left. We can get past it, I promise. Yeah, like I was saying, much tougher of a game than the main HLA campaign for sure. And I'm on story mode too, which is the easiest difficulty, just to emphasize that even more. Like this campaign is very difficult, especially if you're trying to speed past all the enemies. I wonder actually if there's a syringe around here that I could grab. Because honestly, if I could find one here, that just might save my keister. Because usually I have a good amount of hearts going into this area. I just took a lot of damage in a previous chapter. I don't think there is, unfortunately, so I'm gonna go daredevil mode here. I wonder if I can do a sneak attack on this guy. Like shoot him from behind this pipe or something. Okay. There we go, finally. Is there anyone else? I think we're good. Okay. Yeah, I think we're good. So I'm going to do an extended jump to get through this door. You'd normally have to kill a Strider and then deactivate the power to get through here, but, you know, we can just extend the jump to get through it. Very glad I got past that section, by the way, because that was seriously super spooky. Equally spooky, though, is this puzzle. We have to navigate this lock twice around this electric globe to... There we go. To unlock this mechanism, because we want to get through that portal to get to an area called Sector X, which is where Barry and Maya are. But we have to do that little puzzle to activate this mechanism before we can actually do that. I'm going to pull these things out, and I have to rotate these things to create a path for this electric pulse so I can activate the machine. All these cogs are in random rotations, but we got some pretty good patterns there. And finally, I'm going to be able to heal. Because this is a very tough campaign where you can die pretty easily. I'm going to be taking a lot of safety heals in these last few chapters. The last part especially, last part of the game especially has a very tough combat section, so I'm definitely going to be taking a safety heal for that. Gonna dupe some more ammo, just so I have a lot of ammo in reserve for the next chapter. Because similarly to this chapter, there's a lot of enemies we have to deal with. Thankfully, we can skip some of them, but we'll see how that goes. So this is a Vortigaunt. He's going to help us, help teleport us over to Sector X, which is basically like this no-no zone into City 17 that's very dangerous. And that's before they were Barry and Maya are, so we're going to teleport over there. Fortunately, though, we're going to get interrupted by the G-Man right around there. And you'll notice something's a little odd in this cutscene. Because we did not kill the Strider before going into this section, we have our flashlight on here, which you're normally not supposed to have in this cutscene. You're normally just supposed to be sitting here in the void while G-Man is talking. You also hear some droning noises in the background. There it is. That's a Strider that we haven't killed yet. He's just vibing there, essentially. So yeah, Chapter 6 is a very rough chapter. And if runs ever die, it's definitely in Chapter 3 or 6. Because most of the other chapters are fine and I'm pretty consistent at them. But it's just Chapter 6 that gives me a lot of trouble. Because that climb to get up the tower is very rough. We have to wait for this orb to get near us so we can go to Chapter 7. That's definitely how you teleport. Just assert dominance and you're there. Alright, so now we're in Sector X. This is Chapter 7, by the way. There's 8 chapters, so we're getting very close to the end. To start off with in Chapter 7, I'm going to do a zero zip. Gotta give it a second, though, because when the chapter loads in, the game can lag a little bit. There we go, so I've just zero-zipped. Switch back to continuous, and I have to clip into this tunnel right here, right there. But it's very tough, because I'm in an area that the game considers out of bounds, which you can see with the orange on the screen. So I have to very carefully wiggle through this tunnel, so I can actually get back in bounds here. There's going to be some shenanigans IRL to get through. We're getting close, though. We're at the exit of the tunnel. Almost there. There we go. We're in. So that's the hardest clip in the entire game, but I managed. Also going to save here just in case, because there are a couple Combine soldiers down here. I like how that Combine soldier clipped into the other soldier's shield. That was pretty funny. So you're supposed to, again, turn off the power to take down these barriers, but we can just extend a jump through it. I'm going to take one of these X-axes and need it to power a gate later. And there's a couple of antlions here, but we can avoid fighting them by just extended jumping through this barrier. There's a couple of Combine soldiers up here as well. I'm going to be very careful in dealing with them. Because one of these Combine soldiers has this gun that fires very quickly. And he also takes a lot of hits to kill. So I typically just wait around a corner until that Combine soldier is done shooting. And then I kill him with a pistol. Which is the only pistol we get in the run. Or the only gun we get in the run because we skip the rest of them. I also went out of my way to get that exact. I technically could go to this elevator early. But if I go to this elevator without activating that power gate first, this elevator would not activate. I would essentially be softlocked. So I have to power that gate before I can proceed. And you're supposed to do an entire sequence where, again, you turn off the power to deactivate that barrier over there. But, VR speed tech, we can just extend a jump through these. We have a very tough combat sequence coming up after I extend a jump through this door. I'm also going to heal real quick at this health station because I'm going to be taking a lot of hits here. So I need all the health I can get. There you go. So now I have to take these, basically these power rods, take the power out of them with my hands, shoot them at Manhacks if I need to, and drain all the power, essentially. And once I drain all these outlets, essentially, the level will end. But it's very tough, especially in a casual playthrough, because as you can see, there's a bunch of manhacks attacking me. And while they do little bits of damage here and there, and they're not really that threatening, they can really wreck your stuff if you're not careful. And also, if you go into these lasers that come out occasionally, accidentally, you will just get absolutely murdered. Because they'll drain your health very fast. So you need to be very careful in this section. Thankfully, I'm playing on story mode, though, so they don't do too much damage. Oh, nice. So I've drained all the ports. And now the place is going to collapse. There's also this enemy right here. I've forgotten what the actual name of this enemy is, but he's here. Gonna try to kill Barry and Maya very shortly once we get to the last chapter. Like how he just stuck his tongue out at me as well. Alright, so that's toughest section of the game done. No deaths, which is pretty good. Because that fight is very scary. Alright, so now we're in the last chapter of the game, and it's going to be over within 10 seconds. Because at the very start, I'm going to do a zero zip. Right there. I'll switch back to continuous. I'm going to teleport down here, and hit a cutscene there, and that's the end. We're done. So, stop time there, because that's when we lose control. Because there's this cutscene where we come across Barry and Maya. Yeah, I saw the time when I stopped the timer. It was, I stopped a little late because, like, I had to go over to my keyboard to hit spacebar, but that was around a 2240, I think, in real time, which is very good. Very, very nice. Especially considering that, Chapter 6 was a little spooky for a second there. Because, like, I swear, Chapter 6 usually isn't that much of a trouble. It's just things happen and you accidentally get in a bad situation. That's why I always take safety heals when I run this game, even if I'm doing serious attempts, just because this game, casually or speedrun, can absolutely wreck your stuff if you're not careful. But yeah, that's Levitation. Oh, we got an ending scene here where we finally meet up with Barry and Maya. There they are. But unfortunately, some antlions invade our celebration, and so we're going to get put in stasis by G-Man again. Typical of him to do that. Yep, see, there they are. And there's a G-Man. And we'll get a pretty nice scene here as he gives us his closing speech. We'll get put in what I can only describe as the best representation of a M.C. Escher painting in VR. Right here, we get this infinite set of stairs and entryways. There's a G-Man over there. So while we're in this ending cutscene, going into the ending credits, while we look at this nice scenery, I want to give a few shout-outs. First of all, I want to shout the Source Runs community in particular, especially the community surrounding runs of this game and Source 2 stuff in general, because, by the way, this is a Source 2 game, not a Source Engine 1 game. All of them are very nice people and were very helpful with this and the main campaign, with me trying to get really good at it. Also, shouts to FMP1 right there. He's the, as it says there, the lead developer of this mod. Did a very good job with it, for sure. But with the Source Ones people in particular, I want to shout out Lemons and Walpy, because they were very helpful with me getting good at this run and the main campaign. I also want to shout out The Fae Time. He's another runner of the main campaign, and his runs of the main campaign at GDQ in the past were what inspired me to pick up this game and to glitch hunt and run Levitation. And also, if you watching at home are able to play VR in any capacity and with whatever rig you have, definitely try Alyx if you get the chance. It's a very good game, and I especially recommend trying this campaign because both of them are very, very fun. yeah, that's pretty much it for me. Thank you, Osey, and the rest of the Os-a-Thon staff for letting me run this, because it's very unique being able to do a VR run like this for a marathon of any sort. So it's definitely been an interesting experience. But yeah, you can cut me off whenever you want.
Yeah, thank you very much. Mm-hmm. We appreciate it. That said, mm-hmm. We're going to go ahead and get ready for the next run, which I believe is Jack 3. Mm-hmm.